state and local agencies. Jamie Foxx fans are a happy bunch.
It's our birthday!
TMZ video shows the actor smiling and throwing up a peace sign to onlookers as he cruised down the Chicago River on a boat. It's the first sighting of the Oscar winner since he was hospitalized in Georgia in April for an unspecified medical complication. This is CBS News.
Need to hire quality candidates fast? You need Indeed, the end-to-end hiring solution. Attract, interview, and hire candidates all in one place. Visit Indeed.com/credit.
Continue the conversation online. Find and follow Civic Media on Facebook and on Twitter.
For WAUK, The Shaw, I'm Terry Bell, and here's what you need to know. The 55th year of Summerfest is in the books. This was the third year of Summerfest's three-weekend format. Jimmy Buffett and AJR canceled their performances. Summerfest attendance is coming back up since the pandemic, but crowds are still smaller than they were before COVID. The official attendance for this year's Summerfest should be announced sometime this week. The Waukesha teacher who could be fired over Dolly Parton's Rainbowland song has a hearing today. Melissa Temple's a first-grade teacher at Higher Elementary. She tweeted her objections when the song was removed from the school's spring concert. The story has made national news. The district says Temple's response was inappropriate and accuses her of violating district policies. I'm Terry Bell, and this is WAUK News.
Hey, this is Lindsay Kindert at 540 WAUK The Shaw. At Civic Media, we love our local communities and want to share your stories. Submit your local event and we'll let our listeners know. Email me, Lindsay Kindert, at info@civicmedia.us. That's info@civicmedia.us.
This summer, 540 AM WAUK has a new lineup.
Yes, that's awesome.
Starting at 6 AM, Up North News, 8 to 10, The Earl Ingram Show. Mondays, 8 to 9, Under the Helmet with the Grave Digger, Gilbert Brown and Earl Ingram. 10 to 12. As Goes Wisconsin. At noon, Civic Media Network News. At 12:15, Town Call. 1 to 3, The Todd Alba Show. 3 to 4, Matt Flynn Direct. 4 to 6, The Devil's Advocates with Dom and Crute. And 6 to 7, The Maggie Dawn Show. On 540 AM WAUK.
Don't let biased algorithms or degree screens or exclusive professional networks or stereotypes. Don't let anything keep you from discovering the half of the workforce who are stars. Workers skilled through alternative routes rather than a bachelor's degree. It's time to tear the paper ceiling and see the stars beyond it. Find out how you can make stars part of your talent strategy at tearthepaperceiling.org. Brought to you by Opportunity at Work and the Ad Council.
RPG came through the belly of the aircraft. We don't talk about the female combat wounded. These are our daughters and our sisters and our mothers. Wounded Warrior Project came into my life and taught me how to stand back up and get back in the fight. The truth is, I think we all have this strength inside of us, but until you're tested, you just don't know what's there.
What if I just, instead of giving out the talk of text line, just started giving up Robin Voss's number all the time? I'm so cool. 844-96-PARTY. What is it?
I'm so cool. Write it down. 608-237-9163. Call now.
Moving Wisconsin forward, one joke at a time. This is Kristin Bry with As Goes Wisconsin.
Yada, yada, yada.
Hello, Wisconsin!
Is alimony fair? 844-967-2789. Pretty straightforward question. Probably going to get a lot of different answers. I think it's, like most things, very gray. But in your opinion, is having to pay alimony after you get divorced fair? And for how long? Like, what is the adequate amount of time? And this is, you know, at this day and age, now there are women who are the breadwinners. And so there are now women who are paying alimony. Obviously, historically, this has been men paying their ex-wives. But I would love to hear from you. Is alimony fair? Or are we, have we moved beyond that now that women can work and or both spouses are free to work? 844-967-2789. That's 844-96-PARTY. Jane Madner, is alimony fair?
I think I agree with you in that there's a lot of gray there. You know, should you get, if you're only married for 2 years, should you get alimony yes. for the rest of your life? I don't know that that's fair.
I would say no.
Right? I mean, that just seems, yeah. And I think most people go into marriage assuming this is going to last forever.
Yeah. Well,
so I don't think a lot of people do I mean, I know some people do prenups, but I think the average person probably doesn't.
That's a whole other topic.
Yeah.
Because like Mike and I did a postnup, and it's not even like we have that much money to protect, but just in, you know, this was coming into the marriage. This was mine. This was yours. These were our businesses. But it was interesting because that in Wisconsin, it's called spousal maintenance. And that came up during when I met with my lawyer as her trying to explain it to me. And so I think we ended up putting like a sunset provision. Because, you know, for me, it's like, it's as much you expect, one, you expect the marriage to last forever, but also, like, I have every expectation that, like, I'm going to continue working, right? Like,
sure.
That's because that's who I am and stuff. And so, but you just can't predict what's going to happen. And so that's been my only experience thus far with, like, having to make a decision for our postnup. Because you've been married prior to Paul. Did that come up at all for you?
It's something we discussed and then ultimately did not do a prenup.
But did alimony come up at all? Because you were working. You were always working too, right?
Oh, yeah. I've always worked. I've always been working. No, alimony has never come up. Nothing like that. But I get too, Wisconsin's a 50-50 state, right? So
yeah,
you split assets pretty much down the middle.
Yeah. Well, and also there is... I was reading this morning because I'll talk about why I brought this up in just a second. But Wisconsin does have different laws than Florida. But this basically what happened in Florida, why I'm bringing all this up, is Ron DeSantis has signed a bill into law that ends like permanent alimony. And there are a lot of women who are not very happy about it. And so I was like, there's a lot of different ways to go with this. But I just thought the simple question of, is alimony fair? Is a good place to start. So would love to hear from you. 844-967-2789.
Anne is on the phone from Eau Claire. Good morning, Anne. What do you think?
Good morning. So my experience is myself and my husband, current husband, are both retired U.S. Air Force, and we both have ex-spouses. When we divorce, there is an archaic federal law that says that our spouse garners part of our pension. I was married for my entire career, 23 years. He was married for 17 years, 14 years, 14 years of his career. My thoughts are that, A, we don't get any of our pension back for the entire duration of our spouses, ex-spouses' lives until they die. I wish
wow.
that there was a sliding scale. Yeah. It would be fair. Like, he's the man. I gave my GI Bill to him to get his master's degree and all this stuff. So he's making $80,000 a year now, whereas I was living on like $24,000 just on my pension and my disability. It is what it is. There's no point in losing sleep over it. But if for the duration of their raising children, or even the duration of how long we were married, they got a sliding scale of pension, I would be very happy with that. That would be, you know, mm-hmm. fair, because if I was in his shoes, I would appreciate a little bit of pension, a little bit of help getting a leg up. But for life, no. And the same with my ex. He's a Texas resident, and that's their law. I was in Arizona when that happened, but it's still a federal mandate that for military anyways, veterans, and I'm sure there's a lot of people out there that can relate. We lose part of our pension if we've been married for any part of, you know, our military career, and then we divorce.
And that there's no stipulation as far as how long you have to be married. So even if you were only married a year, that's the case.
I'm not sure about that. Honestly, I do know that, you know, a lot of spouses get married mill to mill because there's convenience factors. They get their housing allowance and whatnot. But if you're married long enough to have children and then you get divorced and then you retire, then that pension goes to your ex. Now, if you're not in long enough to retire, you don't get a pension, then of course it's moot, but still.
Still. That's really interesting because that's I mean, this sounds like it's a federal bill for military, but this is the never, like the permanent alimony is what just ended in Florida, which I don't think we have in Wisconsin.
And good for Florida.
Yeah, but I think you're right. Like, I think there is
for Florida.
That's really interesting that you say that. Thanks so much for the call, Anne.
Because Anne.
There's a lot of, like I said, there's a lot of women who are not happy about this. But I also think, is this ever something that should be permanent? Because I totally understand in the, especially when there's kids involved, but this is separate from child support. The idea that I gave up my, especially if you give up your career to focus on the house and split like responsibilities and everything. And then like you take that time off from your career, you have to try to get like work again. You've lost your purchasing, not your purchasing power, but like where you maybe would have been. But you know, if you get divorced at 40, should you still be getting alimony at 65 when your ex wants to retire? I say no.
Yeah, it's and I'd love to hear from some men, because I think, as you pointed out, at least initially, the main burden of paying alimony was on men.
Yeah.
And so I can't imagine that any of them want to be paying alimony for the rest of their ex's life.
No, I mean, I would, I'm sure most of them don't want to be paying alimony immediately. I mean, I have never been divorced, but I think for some people, you don't really like the person when you're first getting divorced. You don't really like that person. And so your desire to pay them anything is not very high.
844-967-2789, 844-96-PARTY. Is alimony fair?
So I'll give you a little more detail on what just happened in Florida. So, on Friday, this came across my, this was the headline. And of course it kind of grabbed me. This is a death sentence for me. Florida Republican women say they will switch parties after DeSantis approves alimony law.
Wow.
Yeah. So Governor Ron DeSantis on Friday signed a measure that will overhaul the state's alimony laws. And this has been an ongoing thing. Rick Scott, This was already happening when Rick Scott was still governor, as far as bills getting proposed. Rick Scott vetoed it twice and DeSantis vetoed it once. And it's been like a decade of clashing over this issue. And so it includes doing away with what's known as permanent alimony. And so along with that, the measure will set up a process for ex-spouses who make alimony payments to seek modifications to alimony agreements when they want to retire. It allows judges to reduce or terminate alimony, support, or maintenance payments after considering a number of factors, such as the age and health of the person who makes the payments and the customary retirement age of that person's occupation, the economic impact of reduction in alimony. So there's like all of these things that I would actually consider, which I think is probably a good thing. But the political side of this is that there's this group called... where did I see it? I don't know if it's as straightforward.
Women for Alimony?
I think it's like First Wives Club or something like that.
On behalf yeah, of, you're right. Yes.
Is it called First Wives Club?
Yes, I believe so. Something very similar.
Oh, God. And I thought I grabbed it, and I'll have to go look at the article again. But this was the quote coming from that organization. On behalf of the thousands of women who our group represents, we are very disappointed in the governor's decision to sign the alimony reform bill. We believe by signing it, he has put older women in a situation which will cause financial devastation. The so-called party of family values has just contributed to erosion of the institution of marriage in Florida. This is a 63-year-old woman who founded the group that we'll find the name of.
First Wives Advocacy Group.
First, I was close. First Wives yeah. Advocacy Group.
Advocacy Group.
And from their point, the quote goes further, saying DeSantis has just impoverished all the older women in Florida. And I know at least 3,000 women across the state of Florida are switching to Democrat, and we will campaign against him all the way forever. So there's political ramifications to this. And I guess if you, this is, comes back to when we talk about like Social Security and Medicare, are these things that you have planned on? And then they go away, because if you are in your 60s and you had thought you were going to get alimony, it's not super easy, I'm sure, to just turn around and go get a job now either.
Not when you're an older woman, trust me. It's not that easy.
So it goes back to my original question. What's fair? And I also have a follow-up question. We can get into the next segment a little bit of like, oh, this is what it took for you to realize you don't like Ron DeSantis, but that's a digression.
That's another one.
Like, now that it affects you, now you're like, oh, now I'll rally against him. But is alimony fair, considering all of the nuance and gray area of this? Where do you fall on the idea of alimony? Separate from child support, but actually spousal support after you get divorced. 844-967-2789. That's 844-96-PARTY. We will take your texts. We will take your calls. If you're watching the live stream right now, you can leave a comment and we will get to those after the break. This is As Goes Wisconsin.
R-D-I-B-O-R-C-E becomes final today. Both, and this will be pure H-E-double-L for me. Oh, I wish that we could stop this D-I.
Attention, Wisconsin veterans.
Hello, I'm Tony Evers, the governor of Wisconsin. If you are a veteran struggling to pay for rent, utilities, or other life-sustaining services, I want you to know that the Veterans Rental Assistance Program is here to help. You have already made a most noble sacrifice. You shouldn't have to continue doing so. We are here to support you. The Veterans Rental Assistance Program was created by and for people living in Wisconsin, with benefit approvals being issued to veterans in just days, not months. It's never easy to ask for assistance, but rest assured, we're here to help. You've always been there for us. We want you to know that we're here for you. Call 833-WISBRAP. That's 833-947-8727, or visit VRAPWI.com. On behalf of the state of Wisconsin, thank you.
This summer, 540 AM WAUK has a new lineup.
Yes, that's awesome.
Starting at 6 AM, Up North News, 8 to 10, The Earl Ingram Show. Mondays, 8 to 9, Under the Helmet with the Grave Digger, Gilbert Brown and Earl Ingram. 10 to 12, As Goes Wisconsin. At noon, Civic Media Network News. At 12:15, Town Call. 1 to 3, The Todd Alba Show. 3 to 4, Matt Flynn Direct. 4 to 6, The Devil's Advocates with Dom and Crute. And 6 to 7, The Maggie Dawn Show on 540 AM WAUK.
Here's your updated forecast on the Shaw. Mainly sunny this afternoon, high in the upper 80s. A few clouds tonight, chance of showers and thunderstorms, low near 66. Slight chance of showers and storms early Tuesday. Mainly sunny, high of 81. Slight chance of rain Tuesday night, low near 59. Cloudy on Wednesday, chance of showers and a few thunderstorms, high of 72. Showers and storms likely Wednesday night. For Civic Media, I'm meteorologist Laura Lockwood. Right now, 75.
And I'm riding around on recap tires.
And you're the reason I'm hanging our clothes outside on wharves.
Is alimony fair? 844-967-2789. And obviously that comes with some conditions. I'm sure anyone who has an opinion on this would say this amount of time, these, you know, how old were we, the health of us, but you know, once you start talking about people who thought that they could depend on this, and like in Florida, they may rule that you are no longer going to be able to receive it. It puts the women or people, mostly women, especially of that age, who it may be hard for them to go get a job and they were relying on this. But also, like, I don't think it's also responsible for alimony payments for men who want to retire. And they're still going to start living off of their retirement either. And so this has popped up because in Florida, Ron DeSantis on Friday signed into law a measure that will overhaul the state's alimony laws, and which does away with permanent alimony, which I don't think we have in Wisconsin. Like, I was trying to look this up before we started the show today, and in Wisconsin, it says the factors to consider for spousal support: length of marriage, age and physical emotional health of both parties, the division of property during the divorce, educational level at each party at the time of marriage and at the time of divorce hearings, the earning capacity of the party seeking maintenance, tax consequences to each party, prenup agreements, contribution by one party to increased earning power of the other. So I don't think this is necessarily, from what I can read, correct me if I'm wrong, it doesn't seem like we have permanent alimony in Wisconsin. So this is a Florida thing, but I think it brings up a really interesting question. 844-967-2789.
Wiley from Mount Pleasant joining us this morning. Hey, Wiley, what do you think?
Well, I've been in the system myself, and again, working for government, and I would see a lot of times when we were doing civil processing, women, as they became more so in the workforce, a lot of women were doing the support, they were doing the alimony, so on and so forth. So the big question on your show is it fair? Is it fair? But one of the big secrets in Racine County and all the other 71 counties in Wisconsin, this is scary, and most people will not even know this number. But in general terms, say I divorce with my three children. I agree that when the judge assesses me, say $1,000 per month, okay?
Okay.
So you go in, when that assessment is made, to the wife, for the ex-wife, for the children's support, the federal government then gets an obligation to bring in to the state of Wisconsin, on that $1,000 a month. That's an assessment of $500 coming from the state to the general circuit court, the counties of the 72 in Wisconsin. So on top of that, another assessment goes from the federal government, and the federal government brings in the assessment amount of $1,000. So each and every, and say in my example here, each and every case like that brings $1,500 a month. That is a whole lot of money for the courts, and to use it for police cars and erasers and chalkboards and trips for the judges. It's all used in a slush fund. We don't hear about that ever. And I'm saying, where are the attorneys?
So there's money that goes from your alimony or one's alimony payments. Some of that money gets siphoned off into a general fund for courthouses.
Well, it's for the county, running the county. I don't want to use the word slush fund. I don't want to get anybody upset about it. But it's the county becomes obligated to bring that money. Like I said, in that case, $1,000 assessment for dad to pay mom. Then the state comes in with $500, and the federal government comes in for $1,000. That's $18,000 a year until these children are of age and they go along the way and along their life. But you don't hear about this. And I've been in the field since 1978 in the law enforcement and civil process work for some of the best attorneys. It's like this boo-boo thing. Don't talk about that. It's scary.
Is it additional money that you're forced to pay, or is a portion of the money you're paying that gets siphoned off?
It's an assessment through the government to the local counties. Okay. It's not coming from me. I pay my $1,000 every month. Okay. But so that's what they gear it on, though, and they target that, and that becomes $1,500 a month until the children. It's like wild, but it's the assessment, and it's all seems like it's kept under the black robe of the judges. Maybe they got big cash piles underneath that thing up there where they sit there with the gavel and everything.
Just bags of money. It's like they're not putting on any weight. That's just the extra cash.
Well, you know, and it's just, I don't I'll tell you, I mean, I've done a lot of things in my life, but, and I love my children. I supported them all the way through, and I never missed the child support payment. But boy, what a big pill to chew on. It's like, what are they doing? And who talks about it? In Racine County, who talks about that money? Do they tell the people in the public that are putting all this money out there and the assessments coming in where that goes? Did they not buy a new SWAT vehicle or did they buy a new car for the sheriff? What are they doing? Where is it going? We need to know that. And I engage a lot of attorneys. Call it in and let's go and I'll take you on. I'll take you.
There we go. Yeah.
Thanks a lot for calling, Wiley. Really appreciate it.
We got to go to another break, but still, if you have thoughts on this topic, is alimony fair? 844-967-2789, or how should it be structured to be more fair? 844-96-PARTY. We'll be back in just a minute.
And go put on a little makeup and get out of that house coat before supper.
Huh. Well, let me tell you something, Conway. Considering everything that I went through today, I look like a movie star.
Yeah. Ruth Buzzy.
Thank you.
Besides that, all of our kids took after your part of the family.
Oh,
anyway.
They did, huh? Well, what about the ones that fall?
This summer, 540 AM WAUK has a new lineup. 10 to 12, As Goes Wisconsin. At noon, Civic Media Network News on 540 AM WAUK.
CBS News Special Report. President Biden is on his way to Lithuania for a NATO summit after a stop in the UK, where he shared tea and talk with the Prime Minister and the King. He reviewed British troops in their scarlet tunics and bearskin hats during his meeting with the King. Correspondent Weijia Jiang was there.
Here at Windsor Castle, President Biden and King Charles focused on climate change over tea, but the bulk of this trip is about the war in Ukraine. Before the president left the U.S., he made clear that he doesn't think it's the right time for Ukraine to join NATO. He's also defending a controversial decision to send weapons to the country that are banned in much of the world.
Before that, Mr. Biden met with Rishi Sunak at 10 Downing Street in London.
Our relationship is rock solid.
He declared their relationship rock solid. The two leaders also discussed developments in Northern Ireland. CBS News Special Report. I'm Deborah Rodriguez.
For WAUK, the Shaw, I'm Terry Bell, and here's what you need to know. A Waukesha teacher who could be fired over Dolly Parton's Rainbowland song has a hearing today. Melissa Temple is a first-grade teacher at Higher Elementary School. She tweeted her objections when the song was removed from the school's spring concert. The story has made national news. The district says Temple's response was inappropriate and accuses her of violating district policies. Improvements are finally done to downtown Waukesha. After 9 years of work, the streets are repaved and the sidewalks are replaced. The streetlights are improved and so are the sewer and water lines. Upgrades to the West Broadway area was the final piece of the puzzle. The project started in 2014 and cost $18.5 million. I'm Terry Bell and this is WAUK News.
Living happily ever after isn't always a reality. If you're over 50 and are considering divorce, attorney Andrea Gage with the Everson Law Firm can provide the guidance you need. Andrea focuses on silver divorces, the kind that get more complicated over time and present unique challenges. A family, multiple properties, significant assets. Andrea and the team at Everson Law have the experience to protect your interests. Call Everson Law to set up an appointment with Andrea today. It's never too late to be happy. Everson Law, 920-435-3734.
This summer, 540 AM WAUK has a new lineup.
Yes, that's awesome.
Starting at 6 AM, Up North News, 8 to 10, The Earl Ingram Show. Mondays, 8 to 9, Under the Helmet with the Grave Digger, Gilbert Brown and Earl Ingram. 10 to 12, As Goes Wisconsin. At noon, Civic Media Network News. At 12:15, Town Call. 1 to 3, The Todd Alba Show. 3 to 4, Matt Flynn Direct. 4 to 6, The Devil's Advocates with Dominic Crute. And 6 to 7, The Maggie Dawn Show on 540 AM WAUK. Okay.
As Goes Wisconsin with Kristin Bry.
What is the grand prize? Is it a fabulous cash prize?
You definitely get to take home the cheese. I know
would
that.
I hope so. Humans aren't necessarily logical creatures. Maybe it is.
Thrill seeking.
It's the thrill of the cheese and the bragging rights.
The first person across the line wins and gets to keep the cheese.
And that's it.
And I think that's it.
As Goes Wisconsin with host Kristin Bry. Weekdays 10 till noon on your local Civic Media radio station and on the Civic Media app.
Join the conversation with your favorite hosts or shows anytime. Follow Civic Media on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Share your thoughts on our social media channels wherever.
Gotta see it to believe it. Sky never looks so blue.
Welcome back to As Goes Wisconsin. I am Kristin Bry. She is Jane Matinair, and we are talking about alimony. And it's not as random as it might sound, because on Friday, Governor Ron DeSantis in Florida signed a bill to end permanent alimony. And there's a lot of women who are not very happy about it. It was the first wives advocacy group.
Yes.
Because the headline read, obviously that's what caught my eye, was, "This is a death sentence for me. Florida Republican women say they will switch parties after DeSantis approves alimony law." And they are now saying that there's going to be thousands of women who are going to leave the Republican Party and campaign against him because of how much of a burden, financial burden, this puts on them with this new law. And so we use that as a jumping off point to just have a conversation about alimony and whether or not it's fair and how long the person who was making more money should have to pay it, because it is different from child support.
Oh,
and
right.
It's something that you can get alimony even if you never had children, right? That's my understanding.
Yep, that's
and
what I understand.
So
too.
I think that there are some considerations, especially at the, you know, and in Wisconsin we do that as far as, can you still work? How long were you not working? Your education level, the disparity between the two incomes, which I think are good, which is, I think this is one of those cases you can't just make a blanket law and think it's going to apply to every case. But also, I get that, you know, if you've been divorced for 20 years, should you really still be getting alimony? 844-967-2789. That's 844-96-PARTY.
Got a couple of texts coming in from the 414. What is fair? Who knows? That's why, in my opinion, the state should stay out of divorce matters. The state is as qualified and just as wise in interfering in the abortion issue. Remember the good old days when Republicans were for less government and less interference in our lives? Let the divorcing couple work it out. Great show. Have a great week. Thank you for that.
Thanks for that text.
From the 541, if I were a judge, I would start with, if the individuals are under 60, alimony should be limited to 5 years and no more than half the duration of the marriage, and stop early upon either party getting engaged. Side note, I thought the GOP was against guaranteed income getting paid without working for it. Well, some of those exes would say that they definitely worked for it.
Yeah, and that's the thing. I'm not trying to discount that, you know, housework is work. And when you've made the decision to split the responsibilities in a household of, you know, and there's been lots of proof that, I forgot exactly how this was around 2018. There was a great Atlantic article. Now I'm going to go find it after the show. That basically talks about the hierarchy of wage earners, and the people who make the most are men who have stay at home wives. Even more so than two couples, like a couple who where both people work. And it's largely because when you can divide the labor between making money, so you only have to focus on making money versus your spouse who is taking care of everything else that needs to happen in the household, that as a single person, you're doing both. As a person where you're both working,
sure,
you're splitting, you know, and there's other things as far as how much more women still do that in a heterosexual couple. But in that hierarchy of, it's really good to be a man who has a stay-at-home wife. And that also doubles down your ability to make even more money. And so in those situations, if you get divorced, she enabled you, arguably, to be able to earn as much as you are earning, right? And so I'm not saying that alimony in total we should do away with. I do think there's like a statute of limitation on it, though.
Well, and I am confused. You would think that this would change the law going forward and not go back retroactively.
And it might. I this was from the article that I found, and I really didn't see many other places where this was written up, but this is from Orlando Weekly. And there could be more in the law that gets into like who this applies to, what's retroactive, what's moving forward. I think it's super interesting, but I also think it's super interesting that this is what's motivating these women to get, you know, some of these Republican women to jump ship and become Democrats. But you know, well, I mean,
it has to happen to you.
It has to happen, right? It's like often we can avoid politics until the politics become personal. And so for so many people, when we fit into certain demographics where largely who's president doesn't make a difference to us, largely who's governor or who your state rep is, like you don't feel it. There's other demographics who absolutely feel it. Right now, across the country, LGBTQ people are definitely feeling it. And like the consequences of elections matter. And there's a lot of people who I think have the, it's not so much that they don't, because politics can be boring. It can be exhausting. But it also, if like it's not actually impacting your life yet, there's no motivation to track what's going on. And so, you know, once it kind of works its way into your pocketbook,
yeah,
then maybe you're like, oh,
wait a minute.
This sucks.
Yeah, this was bad.
I want to change this.
This was bad. Why are you doing this to me?
But it was interesting because like you, with the text, I think it was the first text you just read, as far as the, like our decision to get a post-nup, I wish we had it on because I had this as a topic for us to cover a while ago and then it just never came up. There was a great TikTok from a woman who is a lawyer and she argues for why you get a prenup. Cause like, she's like, you have a prenup either way, either the government's writing it or you're writing it.
She's got a good point.
And because like either way, there's going to be an agreement if this marriage ends and how much do you want the government involved versus how much do you want it dictated on what you guys decide? Because either way, it's happening.
Right.
And she just reframed it in a way that I think made it really obvious as far as if you don't want, you know, if you want less, the government less involved in your relationship, you got to hire a lawyer.
In the long run, it's probably a much better idea.
Yeah. Yeah, probably. All right. Well, let's move on to some headlines on this Monday, July 10th. Some good, the bad, and the dangerous. So let's start with the good, at least the good in my opinion. You know, every once in a while you get through a Friday thinking that it's the weekend, thinking you can just like close your laptop, get on with the weekend, you know, hit the road to go camping.
Right.
And then you check Twitter and you're like, oh, some news dropped. That feels like kind of a big deal. And, you know, that Friday news energy. But on Friday afternoon, a Dane County judge allowed a lawsuit seeking to invalidate Wisconsin's 1849 abortion law to proceed. So what does that mean? So basically, Judge Diane Schlipper, I think it's Schlipper.
It is now.
It's like slipper with a slur. also signaled she didn't. She believed that the 19th century statute applied to consensual medical abortions. So basically, she denied a motion to dismiss the suit from Sheboygan District Attorney Joel Ermansky. So basically, he had filed a motion wanting to dismiss the case altogether. She said no. So now the case is going forward and she will continue to hear the case.
Okay.
And while what we don't know. This, at least what she ruled on Friday, is, I think, probably an indicator of where this case is heading. And then after that, there will likely be another appeal, and this will end up in front of the Supreme Court. So this is basically the green light for this case in Wisconsin when it comes to our 1849 ban to find that to be illegal.
Right.
That case is now able to continue going, and that dropped on Friday afternoon.
Good.
Yeah. So that's why I was like, this is, for me, this is good news. And I had someone leave a comment on a TikTok that I made about it, just kind of reporting that it happened. I was like, oh, you're celebrating judges legislating from the bench. I was like, did you not just see what happened in the Supreme Court rulings that just came down? Like,
thank you.
We're past that, buddy. Like, we are past that as far as, like, yes, ideally, no, we do not want judges legislating from the bench. Is it happening? Absolutely. So a win's a win.
And just a little reminder that Amy Coney Barrett, Neil Gorsuch, and Brett Kavanaugh all lied in their hearings when they said that abortion was set precedent and they were going to leave it alone.
Yep.
That was a lie.
It was. On multiple things.
Yes.
On multiple things, not just Roe versus Wade.
Right.
All right. Well, the bad maybe shouldn't surprise anyone in Wisconsin, because we've been hearing about PFAS for a while. But a new study came out that says forever chemicals detected in nearly half of U.S. tap water.
Wow.
At least 45% of U.S. tap water is estimated to be contaminated with forever chemicals, according to a new U.S. Geological Survey research. And basically, they tested for the presence of 32 types of forever chemicals in water samples from more than 700 locations across the U.S. over a five-year period, and used the data to estimate PFAS contamination nationwide, and found that it's like 45%.
Wow.
And there's definitely a lot in Wisconsin, especially by the Mississippi River. But it looks like there's a ton on the East Coast in like around New York and Pennsylvania. There's a lot of clusters. There's a big cluster in Florida. There's a big cluster in Colorado. So not great.
Well, and because even if you have a filtration system, which like we do, it goes through our fridge, the tap water goes through the fridge and a filter and whatever, and we get our cold water. But it's my understanding that those filters don't filter out PFAS.
I don't think they do. I mean, basically, I think we covered it a while ago now, but there's a UK research that's happening with there's like been movement on actually being able to filter out and destroy the PFAS, but I'm not sure that's coming to like a Brita filter near you anytime soon.
Still a work in progress.
Yeah, seriously. All right. And then the dangerous. Stop throwing things at artists.
Seriously.
Over
serious.
I don't know. Who are these people? Have you just lost all etiquette of knowing how to attend a concert? Like, what is happening? And after reading this, it's happened to Harry Styles multiple times.
Really?
So he was hit in the face again by an object thrown during a Vienna concert over the weekend. But this is not, I mean, it's been happening to a fair amount of artists, but it's happened to him like four or five times already, with like once it was a Skittle, once it was, the bouquet of flowers in Wales. He was hit with Skittles, a tampon, and chicken nuggets. He dodged those and made light of the situation. But once again, something was thrown at him. But this is happening to more and more artists in general. And so stop doing that. Stop throwing things at artists while they're performing and injuring them. And if you don't, Adele might shoot a t-shirt at you. Do we have time?
We do. It's real quick. Take a listen.
Adele was calling out fans that have been throwing things on stage out. Well, someone threw a phone at Bebe Rexha and hit her. I talked about another fan throwing their mom's ashes on stage as Pink was performing. And most recently, a fan threw a toy on stage as Lil Nas was performing. Well, here's what Adele had to say as she performed.
That is how people are like to get a show.
It's a lot of beeps.
No, yeah, well, yeah, we had, there were a fair amount of beeps in there, but she basically said, you throw something at me, I'm going to effing kill you.
And she had like a big like t-shirt gun with her on stage, like the Gruber ones from the Bucks games. But yeah, don't throw things at concerts at artists. Why? That's not a way. This is not middle school where you like hit the girl that you like. Like, Jesus. All right. When we come back, I have a fun camping story of someone we met while in Governor Dodge over the weekend who is a fan of the show. And so we'll get to that after the break. This is As Goes Wisconsin.
Save big money on your next project with 11% off everything now at Menards. Get the last roof you'll ever need with Menards Steel Roofing. Steel Roofing adds value to your home, offers superior wind and hail resistance, and can help you save on cooling costs. Get 11% off all Menards Steel Roofing and get started on your next project today. Good through July 9th. Savings are a mail-in rebate. Some exclusions apply. See store for details.
Save big money at Menards.
This summer, 5:40 a.m. WAUK has a new lineup.
Yes, that's awesome.
Starting at 6 a.m. Up North News, 8 to 10, The Earl Ingram Show. Mondays, 8 to 9, Under the Helmet with the Grave Digger, Gilbert Brown and Earl Ingram. 10 to 12, As Goes Wisconsin. At noon, Civic Media Network News. At 12:15, Town Call. 1 to 3, The Todd Alba Show. 3 to 4, Matt Flynn Direct. 4 to 6, The Devil's Advocates with Dom and Crute. And 6 to 7, The Maggie Dawn Show. On 5:40 a.m. WAUK.
A no-holds-barred political conversation. That's Matt Flynn Direct.
Anybody running against Trump, if he calls them a nasty name, they should hit him back twice as hard. This is not the Marcus of Queensberry gentleman's rules anymore. In politics, certainly not in the Republican Party. Hit him hard.
Matt Flynn Direct. Weekday afternoons from 3 until 4 on the Civic Media Network and on the Civic Media app. Log on civicmedia.us.
Here's your updated forecast on the Shaw. Mainly sunny this afternoon, high in the upper 80s. A few clouds tonight, chance of showers and thunderstorms, low near 66. Slight chance of showers and storms early Tuesday. Mainly sunny, high of 81. Slight chance of rain Tuesday night, low near 59. Cloudy on Wednesday, chance of showers and a few thunderstorms, high of 72. Showers and storms likely Wednesday night. For Civic Media, I'm meteorologist Laura Lockwood. Right now, 75.
Oh, there ain't no bugs on me. There ain't no bugs on me. There may be bugs on some new mugs, but there ain't no bugs on me.
Welcome back to As Goes Wisconsin. I am Kristen Bry. She is Jane Matinere, and I live to tell about camping while 7 months pregnant.
How is the belly?
The belly was fine. But yes, yeah, so on Friday, we headed out of town and went to Governor Dodge by Dodgeville. So went through Madison, and it was, first of all, that park is incredible.
Really?
Oh yeah. I would totally. That's the camping site itself was big and like spacious, and the lake that is there to like, there was a pet area and stuff like that. So Cliff proved to be a very good camping dog, which was our first test run of that. Mike did buy like an extra tall, I should say, air mattress. So,
oh, nice.
So that certainly saved me, but yeah, it was, overall, it was fine. It was,
great.
You know, no less comfortable than I usually am in general these days, but I want to give a big shout out to Ben Gruber. So we're at the campsite. Half our group is like on a hike somewhere, and I'm walking around with my belly. Like I have a flowy dress on, and a DNR officer walks by, and he's, you know, like fully suited up, and he's checking campsites. And I have both dogs that we were with on leashes. So I'm thinking, like, thank God I have him on leashes, because that's the rule, right? Like, if you're going to have dogs, they have to be on like an 8-foot leash. So, like, thankfully, Cliff's not walking around. And so he kind of looks at he's looking at our little area, and there's like my sister-in-law, Mike, and I are just the only ones hanging out. And he looks at me and he goes, "Are you Kristin?" And I go, what? Yes. And he goes, "How was that egg crate?" Because he had listened to the show on Friday when I had talked about
going
to Governor Dodge specifically and that I was going to sleep on it. I had an extra egg crate. And so he was like, he had been listening to the show in WRCE because I asked. And he was like, "All right, I'm going to have to keep an eye out for a 7-month pregnant woman like hanging out at Governor Dodge this weekend."
And he found you.
And he found me. And so he stuck around and we talked for a while, which was super interesting to hear more of his stories of like what his job is like working at that at the park and like the different kinds of things that he does in his position. He used to be an EMT firefighter. But then it was really fun because then he came back when all the kids were there in his actual truck.
Oh,
as he pulled back around, and especially to Mike's cousin's kid, who's a 3-year-old boy. The other ones are girls, but the girls liked it too. He had them all come over. He let them all sit in the truck and have the lights go.
Oh,
and stuff like that. So big shout out to Ben Gruber if you're listening. That was a very fun. You made the kids' afternoon, but also you made my day because it was fun to hear someone who was listening to the show.
Absolutely, and when it's random like that, you know what I mean? It's just very, very special. It is.
It is really special. It is. So that was a fun experience that I was excited to share with you. But yeah, overall
was it very buggy?
Only flies. There was like no mosquitoes.
Oh wow.
I don't think it's been so dry. It must be, because I didn't come back with a single mosquito bite, but there was a lot of flies. But that was kind of it. Otherwise it was a little drizzly on Friday evening when we got there, but Saturday was beautiful. Sunday we packed up, came home, and overall it was a good weekend.
That's great. That's awesome.
I think that's it though. I don't think I will be going camping again this summer.
I think that would be wise.
I think I've hit my limit for my one time for this summer, but
wait until next summer when she's here. And
yeah, that's what I said. I was like, I also reserve my right next summer to not go for 2 nights because I don't know if an 8-month baby, I really want to do 2 nights camping with it. Maybe one is fine. If you have suggestions on camping with a kid with who's infants. Under one, let me know, because it is an annual trip that we'll have to go back and do this all again next year. But I didn't grow up camping, and I have to say, I'm good. I'm good for like 2 days.
That's enough.
Yeah. And then it's kind of like, all right, like we can go back now.
And I want a shower that doesn't have spiders in it, or at least not such noticeable spiders.
I did not see any spiders in the shower.
Really?
No.
Really?
No, it was, again, Governor Dodge, shout out to the facilities were pretty clean. The bathrooms were clean. The showers were clean.
Nice.
Like, it was overall very good, very good experience. 10 out of 10. All right. Well, some other Wisconsin news from this week. Thursday night, for anyone who is a stargazer, it's going to be possible for you to be able to see the northern lights between 10 p.m. and 2 a.m. Thursday night into Friday morning. And so,
which doesn't happen. That just doesn't happen here.
I know. So is that something you would stay up to try to see, or are you kind of like, meh?
I would like to see the northern lights.
I would like to see the northern lights too.
I would.
And so I don't know how far up. Journal Sentinel wrote this up, so I'll have to see how far north you have to be, but if you're like in Milwaukee, you'll be able to see it.
I'm pretty sure they said in Milwaukee, we should be able to see it. You're going to still have to get away from some of the city lights though, I would
think. All right. Well, that's good. And then in not so good bug Wisconsin news, a horse in Dunn County has tested positive for West Nile virus, which means that it's in Wisconsin. So whether it's a human or horse, this means infected mosquitoes are present in Wisconsin with West Nile virus. So much more important to you, like, wear long sleeves when you can, use insect repellent, take steps to control mosquitoes indoors and outdoors. I recently heard that bubbles keep mosquitoes away, like a bubble machine. Which is kind of a fun way to, more fun than just putting a citronella candle everywhere.
Absolutely.
So
a bubble maker constantly. I could get behind that.
Yeah, I could get behind that.
It's for sure.
That and get some strobe lights. It'll be perfect.
Right.
All right. Well, coming up in the next hour, we are going to be talking to former Lieutenant Governor Barbara Lawton and Ari Middleman of Keep Our Republic. You might have heard of this a couple weeks ago when Kathy Brenier was announced that there was going to be a Wisconsin branch of this organization and that she was going to be heading up the Wisconsin Council. But they are both here to talk about what Keep Our Republic is, which is a bipartisan group founded in 2020 to shore up confidence in U.S. elections. So we'll talk to them about how their group differs from some of the other groups that are trying to tackle this issue as we head into 2024. And then at 11:30, some news broke.
Yes.
Was it Friday or Saturday?
It was Friday.
Business Journal. So Friday, Milwaukee Business Journal let the cat out of the bag that one of our guest co-hosts while I'm on maternity leave is going to be none other than other Wisconsin, Southeast Wisconsin radio legend, Carol King. And so she's going to join us and talk about her on Fridays come this fall, what her and Jane are going to be talking about and just kind of her career in general in radio. So stick around for that. We're going to take a break for the top of the hour news and be back in just a minute. This is As Goes Wisconsin.
Oh, ain't no bugs on me, girls. There may be bugs on some of you mugs, but there ain't no bugs on me.
Your hopes and dreams? What matters most to you? For over 100 years, Thrivent has helped clients like you find financial solutions for life's important goals. Explore a full range of options, from financial advice and investments to insurance, banking, and generosity programs. To have a heart-to-heart about your finances, contact Mandy Roberts, who you may recognize as Mandy Wright. Call her at 715-470-1303. 715-470-1303. Mandy Roberts proudly serves the Central Wisconsin area. For more details, visit thrivent.com/disclosure.
Hey, this is Lindsay Kindert at 540 WAUK The Shaw. At Civic Media, we love our local communities and want to share your stories. Submit your local event and we'll let our listeners know. Email me, Lindsay Kindert, at info@civicmedia.us. That's info@civicmedia.us.
You're listening to The Shaw.
WAUK 540 AM Jackson. W266 DR Waukesha.
And always streaming on the Civic Media app.
This is CBS News on the Hour, presented by Indeed.com.
I'm Steve Kathan. Confrontation in a Florida prison and a disgraced former sports doctor is wounded. CBS's Jim Krasula.
Larry Nassar is said to be in stable condition after being stabbed several times by another inmate at the federal prison in Coleman, Florida. He is serving a 175-year prison sentence after admitting he sexually assaulted female athletes at Michigan State University and at Indianapolis-based USA Gymnastics, including Olympic medalists.
Overseas, London correspondent Vicky Barker has more on President Biden's meeting today with King Charles.
The president stood with his hand on his heart as the Welsh Guards played the national anthem. King Charles standing at attention by his side. The body language of the two men was relaxed. They see eye to eye on climate and were meeting with philanthropists and investors about combating climate change.
Next stop for Mr. Biden, a NATO summit in Lithuania.
As world leaders gather in Vilnius, Lithuania's government says it's been hit by a wave of cyber attacks. Denial of service attacks designed, it says, to overwhelm the internet there. They've targeted government websites, tourism, and public transportation sites, basic services, the government says, that are needed for visitors.
That's CBS's Cammy McCormick. People in many parts of the Northeast are cleaning up and drying out after a day of torrential rain caused flooding and is blamed for at least one death. CBS's Errol Barnett is in West Point, New York.
Behind me, you can still hear the sound of the water rushing down this cliff. Below where we are, earth-moving machines trying to clean things up. Governor Kathy Hochul has already issued a state of emergency for this and other counties. Truly, the water moved so swiftly last night, it instantly turned roads into rivers.
There have been hundreds of flight cancellations today in the Northeast. It's only going to get hotter in parts of the Southwest. In Arizona, Arizona, KPHO-TV's Holly Box says today will be the 10th straight day temperatures top 110.
A very hot week ahead, 111 Monday and Tuesday, 113 Wednesday, and there's that warm-up, 116 Friday and into Saturday.
There's a manhunt in northwest Pennsylvania for a murder suspect who used bed sheets to escape from jail. State Police Lieutenant George Bivens is leading the hunt for Michael Burham.
We do consider Burham to be armed and dangerous. We ask that anyone who thinks they may see him not approach him.
Experts have begun a dig in central Nebraska in a field to try to find the bodies of more than 80 children who were buried at a Native American boarding school that closed in 1931. Wall Street, the Dow is up 124. This is CBS News.
Find great hires fast with Indeed. Their end-to-end hiring solution makes it easy to attract, interview, and hire candidates all in the same place. Visit Indeed.com/credit.
Your hometown radio, refreshed. Keeping you informed, entertained, and connected on the Civic Media Network. CivicMedia.us.
For WAUK The Shaw, I'm Terry Bell. Here's what you need to know. Improvements are finally done to downtown Waukesha. After 9 years of work, the streets are repaved and the sidewalks are replaced. Streetlights are improved and so are the sewer and water lines. Upgrades to the West Broadway area were the final piece of the puzzle. The project started in 2014 and cost $18.5 million. The 55th year of Summerfest is in the books. This was the third year of Summerfest's three-weekend format. Jimmy Buffett and AJR canceled their performances. Summerfest attendance is coming back up since the pandemic, but crowds are still smaller than they were before COVID. The official attendance for this year's Summerfest should be announced sometime this week. I'm Terry Bell, and this is WAUK News.
Attention, Wisconsin veterans.
Hello, I'm Tony Evers, the governor of Wisconsin. If you are a veteran struggling to pay for rent, utilities, or other life-sustaining services, I want you to know that the Veterans Rental Assistance Program is here to help. You have already made a most noble sacrifice. You shouldn't have to continue doing so. We are here to support you. The Veterans Rental Assistance Program was created by and for people living in Wisconsin, with benefit approvals being issued to veterans in just days, not months. It's never easy to ask for assistance, but rest assured, we're here to help. You've always been there for us. We want you to know that we're here for you. Call 833-WISBRAP. That's 833-947-8727. Or visit VRAPWI.com. On behalf of the state of Wisconsin, thank you.
With one call, the Civic Media Network of stations can deliver your business's message to the entire state of Wisconsin.
Or your hometown.
Marketing plans that work for your business. One call can do it all. Civic Media, 608-819-8255. This summer, 540 AM WAUK has a new lineup.
Yes, that's awesome.
Starting at 6 AM, Up North News, 8 to 10, The Earl Ingram Show. Mondays, 8 to 9, Under the Helmet with the Grave Digger, Gilbert Brown and Earl Ingram. 10 to 12, As Goes Wisconsin. At noon, Civic Media Network News. At 12:15, Town Call. 1 to 3, The Todd.
That's what we like to do on this show. Find the comedy gold.
I just like non-fungible as a word.
It is a good word.
It's a wonderful, it just has a good mouth feel.
La-di-da, la-di-da, la-la.
Moving Wisconsin forward, one joke at a time. This is Kristin Bry with As Goes Wisconsin.
Yada, yada, yada.
Hello, Wisconsin!
Hello, Wisconsin. Welcome to the 11 o'clock hour of As Goes Wisconsin. I am your host, Kristin Bry, along with Jane Matinair, our producer extraordinaire. And coming up this hour at 11:30, we're going to be talking to Carol Kane. We're very excited to announce that on Fridays, once I leave for maternity leave, this fall. She is going to join Jane, and they're going to have a lot of fun on Fridays. And so she's going to, now that that cat's out of the bag, she's going to be joining us at 11:30 to talk more about her and her career as a radio person in Southeast Wisconsin. But right now, you may, if you follow the news closely, may have remembered reading about a month ago that Keep Our Republic, a bipartisan group founded in 2020 to shore up confidence in U.S. elections, announced the launch of its Wisconsin chapter. And so here to tell us more about the organization, what the focus is, how it differs from other small D democracy campaigns is Ari Mittleman, who serves as the executive director of Keep Our Republic. How you doing, Ari?
I'm good. How are things up there?
Things are also good here. And then we're also joined by Barbara Lawton, who was the first woman elected to Wisconsin Lieutenant Governor and served from 2003 to 2011. And she also sits on Wisconsin's Advisory Council for Keep Our Republic. How you doing, Barbara?
Well, thank you.
Absolutely. So I guess, Ari, we'll start with you. If you could, since you're the executive director, could you start with just a further description than what I just laid out as far as what Keep Our Republic is?
Sure thing. And congratulations in advance on the little one.
Thank you.
Time. We have a three-year-old. So Keep Our Republic, as you mentioned, came about in the spring of 2020. It was at the time, it was just ad hoc on Zoom screens, elder statesmen from both parties who had seen the civil unrest of 68 and the corruption of Watergate and the church committee, and really thinking, like, how does one administer an election, regardless of who was in the White House at the time? How are we going to administer an election in a global pandemic? We just knew that we were sailing into quite the hurricane. I don't think anyone at the time knew how tumultuous it was going to be. And what we realized, number one, is we had to incorporate, and we did, and we're a 501c3. Number two, the post-election period, meaning from election night onward through the Electoral College, and then as the world saw and learned what happens with the certification in Congress, it's just a period of time that I think folks have taken for granted and throughout America's history and generally have not examined and studied the weaknesses and pressure points.
So this is something that was
that's what we have been up to. And, and every state is, you know, somewhat nuanced in how they, they canvass the votes, so they certify the votes. Presidential elections have pretty strict guidelines, guardrails, if you will, of when the Electoral College should meet. But in that period in between, there's differences between the states, and that's where we come in.
And that's so interesting because so this started before the election was over. This started just there are so many that I think popped up post 2020 election because of the election denialism and everything. But this was something that you guys saw the writing on the wall even before knowing just what was going to happen with having the election during COVID.
Well, I would encourage your audience, if they have a bit of time, it's the word that comes to mind is eerie. I just checked it out before we got on. But we did a lot of programming in the weeks leading up to the November 2020 election. And the last program we did was with several hundred attorneys from across Pennsylvania for the Pennsylvania Bar Institute. And it was Governor Ridge and Tom Ridge, former DHS secretary, and others literally just walking the participants through the calendar. And one of the last sections of that walkthrough was they said, and then there's January 6th, and it's fairly pro forma, and this is what happens, and the whole world saw what happened.
That is very true. So then, Barbara, how did you get involved?
And that literally that event was Wednesday before Election Day.
Wow. So then, Barbara, how did you get involved with Keep Our Republic?
By invitation from our from our Wisconsin chair, Kathy Bernier, who is a former Republican state senator, but also a former village or town clerk or county clerk, who had the courage to stand up to her colleagues who were election deniers and wanting to put forward false voters, electoral voters after the 2020 election. And so she and the national group were cobbling together a bipartisan group of former elected officials who really understand the risk that we're under and who are willing to forge a shared agenda as we work across the state to try to restore confidence in our system. We suffered in Wisconsin a legislature, a Republican-led investigation that went on for years and millions of dollars of taxpayer money spinning out all sorts of false information and undermining public confidence. And of course, yep. Keep Our Republic wants everybody to know that that we are a nonpartisan group absolutely determined to protect these institutions of our democracy and make sure that every eligible voter really has a chance to vote. We've had a lot of challenges to that in Wisconsin, that their vote will count and that the electoral vote will stand. But we, as we look at the most vulnerable places across the state where election officials have had threats, et cetera, we need to do a big public education project and engage people in ensuring that their system is both protected and that people have confidence in it.
And we're talking to Barbara Lawton, who was the first woman elected to the Wisconsin Lieutenant Governor, and she also sits on the Wisconsin Advisory Council for Keep Our Republic, and Ari Middleman, who serves as the Executive Director for Keep Our Republic. And you said the bipartisan group, because it's a nonpartisan organization, but Tommy Thompson is sitting on this advisory council, Bill McCosh, who's been on our show before, David Bowen, who's a Democrat from Milwaukee. And so what has it been like? Like, what was it like to kind of get that group together, and how has it been? I guess no one's currently serving, I don't think. You can
no,
correct me
and
if
nor
wrong.
Should Everyone's, they be.
Yeah,
and
so how has that been as far as, does it feel very easy, or is there conflict that comes up with that?
Well, we haven't been gathered for that long to find out. We have a retreat coming up. We've had some meetings on phone and some education sessions for us. But what I find is that everybody is focused on the same goal, which is to ensure that Wisconsin has free and fair elections, and that our state voters all feel confident in that. And we all know the risks that are coming because we've watched them unfold here. I mean, this is it's frightening to me. It's unnerving. Right now, the head of our Wisconsin Election Commission, who is hired by a bipartisan group in equal number, you know, it was designed in our constitution by law to be a dysfunctional group in that sense. But they unanimously named her as the director of the Election Commission a few years ago, and now she's up to be renominated or to be rehired. And there's a great deal of controversy around that because the state Senate is upset that she's done her job so well. She has the confidence of all of the town and village and county clerks across the state. And she has really gained national recognition for the quality and the integrity of her work. But we're in a moment of crisis one more time. So the work of Keep Our Republic, we're so glad they decided to focus on Wisconsin. It's essential.
And so, Ari, speaking, so with Keep Our Republic.
I would add to that, I'm sorry.
No, go ahead.
I was just going to say that, much to our surprise, very similarly in Pennsylvania, the work has attracted disproportionately, I'd say 60-40, those who were appointed who were elected as Republicans, meaning retired federal judges, retired U.S. attorneys, even the retired former Republican governor, Tom Corbett, is chairing our efforts, and every week is quite active. And I think to a person, what I've heard as we're building out these tremendous volunteer advisory councils, and advisory councils maybe is a misnomer. I mean, really working groups and folks ready to roll up their sleeves and just help with this bipartisan civic education, is that the folks have said, we just need to lower the temperature. You know, 2020, we had never seen anything like this. There's just so much misinformation. There's distrust. you know, our communities are being ripped apart at the seams going into these tribal camps.
And Ari, we need to model that kind of dialogue, right? And that's one of the public values of Keep Our Republic, is that we have people who haven't agreed on much before who are modeling a very determined and cooperative dialogue about how we can set things aright.
And that's actually what I'd love. We're coming up against a break right now, but when we come back, I would love to hear more about what is planned, what Keep Our Republic has planned in Wisconsin ahead of 2024, which is coming, which is barreling at us very, very quickly. And I know that there's some seminars that are going to be happening. Would love to talk more about that. Our guests this half hour are Barbara Lawton, who sits on the Wisconsin Advisory Council for Keep Our Republic and was Wisconsin's Lieutenant Governor from 2003 to 2011, and Ari Middleman, who is the Executive Director of Keep Our Republic. If you have any questions for either of them about Keep Our Republic or the 2024 election, feel free to shoot us a text, 844-967-2789. We're going to take a quick break and be back in just a minute. This is As Goes Wisconsin.
I know you're waking for the CIA. They would have you in the bye-bye.
Does your financial strategy include your hopes and dreams? What matters most to you? For over 100 years, Thrivent has helped clients like you find financial solutions for life's important goals. Explore a full range of options, from financial advice and investments to insurance, banking, and generosity programs. To have a heart-to-heart about your finances, contact Mandy Roberts, who you may recognize as Mandy Wright. Call her at 715-470-1303. 715-470-1303. Mandy Roberts proudly serves the Central Wisconsin area. For more details, visit thrivent.com/disclosure.
This summer, 540 AM WAUK has a new lineup.
Yes, that's awesome.
Starting at 6 AM, Up North News, 8 to 10, The Earl Ingram Show. Mondays, 8 to 9, Under the Helmet with the Grave Digger, Gilbert Brown and Earl Ingram. 10 to 12, As Goes Wisconsin. At noon, Civic Media Network News. At 12:15, Town Call. 1 to 3, The Todd Alba Show. 3 to 4, Matt Flynn Direct. 4 to 6, The Devil's Advocates with Dom and Chris. At 6 to 7, The Maggie Dodd Show on 540 AM WAUK.
Hey everybody, how we doing? I'm Charlie Behrens, inviting you to join me Saturdays and or Sundays at noon. It's a horse apiece, whatever you decide. We're doing the Cripes Cast, where we talk to people for and or from the Midwest, and it's more fun than a six-pack of Jolly Cuts. Okay, the pride of Random Lake, that Jolly Good is. Anyway, it's on your Civic Media station and the Civic Media app. And do me a favor, yeah, tell your folks I says hi. Okay, real good.
Here's your updated forecast on the Shaw. Mainly sunny this afternoon, high in the upper 80s. A few clouds tonight, chance of showers and thunderstorms, low near 66. Slight chance of showers and storms early Tuesday. Mainly sunny, high of 81. Slight chance of rain Tuesday night, low near 59. Cloudy on Wednesday. Chance of showers and a few thunderstorms, high of 72. Showers and storms likely Wednesday night. For Civic Media, I'm meteorologist Laura Lockwood. Right now, 79.
Welcome back to As Goes Wisconsin. I am Kristin Bry. She is Jane Madnair, and we are talking to Barbara Lawton, who sits on the Wisconsin Advisory Council for Keep Our Republic, along with Ari Middleman, who is the Executive Director of Keep Our Republic, which is a nonpartisan civic action organization dedicated to protecting our laws and strengthening the checks and balances in our electoral system. So, Ari, coming up, obviously, we are barreling towards our 2024 election, and I would say living in Wisconsin right now, there's feelings like it could be contentious again, but we did get through 2022 without a lot of fanfare. But I guess, what are some of the activities and what's planned as far as from Keep Your Republic to try to make 2024 go smoothly?
Well, you are correct. I'm one of those weird people in Washington that has a countdown, and we are less than 485 days, 483 to be exact. and I do think that Wisconsin will be ground zero. I mean, 21,000 votes is not a lot. I say that as a proud Pennsylvanian, and we could argue what the Keystone State is, but so we're going to be ramping up as early as just 2 weeks from now, on July 31st, up in Chippewa County and the two adjacent counties up in the northwest corner of Wisconsin. An evening kickoff of what we're calling a community engagement educational seminars. We have the clerks from the county coming out. We have the sheriffs from the county coming out. And generally just kind of civic leaders, not necessarily folks who are political, but folks who are active in the community, be them in their congregations, and VFWs, et cetera, in the legal community. Once again, the name of the game is really educating folks about what happens to your ballot after you do your part by casting it on election day. I'll tell you a very quick story. I seem to mention this almost every day because I think it just illustrates our point. We were up in La Crosse, Wisconsin in February, quietly doing some fact finding and building out this great Wisconsin Advisory Council. And I won't say who, but someone who is, I think, very prominent in Wisconsin politics, no longer serves in office. He said, you know, until we sat down today, I knew how to get my people out to the polls. I knew where our election night party was going to be, and I knew which supporters I was going to bus to Madison. I never stopped and thought about what happens around Thanksgiving with the counting and the certification of my ballot. And if someone at that level of political prominence, who had devoted a good chunk of his professional career to being in public life, had never stopped and thought about it, then I think the average Wisconsin resident hasn't. And we just need to trust the process and really build trust in that process.
Well, that's actually, as someone who was an elected official, Barbara, had you thought much about it? Like, was it something that you were familiar with?
Unfortunately, yes. When I do a lot of mentoring, and as I will tell someone who is shocked by something they learn, just when you think you've lost your innocence, you'll find there's more to lose. And I lost innocence in terms of understanding that in my first run for office, which I lost. But there were some disturbing irregularities in the vote count and in delay of getting the ballots to the center place where they were going to be counted. So unfortunately, yes. I think this event in northwestern Wisconsin in Chippewa County is a really interesting and important launch. It's the home area of our chair of the Wisconsin Council, but it's also an area that is in the Minnesota media market. And this is one of the challenges that we have in Wisconsin, is that there are large portions of the population over there up in the Marinette area, they're in a Michigan market, down in Rockford, they're in a Chicago market, that to find a way to really help the residents of that area understand what's afoot and how to feel like they're in Wisconsin and have a responsibility alongside us to make this all work.
That's so interesting, because I actually last week I had posted a video asking people what they wanted to hear about. And it was kind of surprising how many comments I got from people exactly in those districts that you were talking about.
Oh,
that
really?
Say, we don't get local news here.
Right.
Like getting our stories and hearing what's happening in Madison, like they have to go to social media because they're, I mean,
right? It goes beyond there. I think there's 12 or 14 or something dailies that are owned by Gannett. And so they're the majority USA Today, but not very much local. So we have a media challenge. Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. So I guess in the couple minutes we have left, this is for both of you. If people want to get involved, if people want to learn more, where would you direct them as far as what they can do when it comes to the organization that Keep Our Republic is doing in Wisconsin?
to the website.
Okay.
Keep Our Republic.
Yeah, definitely go to keepourrepublic.com or .org. I always have to point out that's tour. It's our with an R and then republic with an R. So there's two R's in the middle. Keepourrepublic.org.
Perfect. Yeah. And then I guess on a more hopeful note, what have either of you seen firsthand work as far as people who have their skepticism about what happened in 2020 and what kind of information, if they get access to it, makes them start to trust elections again?
When they get information from a neighbor or a friend or somebody that they know and trust. And so that's why this kind of work and the outreach that we're doing with the state council, and like in Chippewa Falls, and we'll be designing where else we'll be going in the state, is so critical to kind of put this in the hands of the people in the community and let them do their magic for us.
Absolutely. All right. Well, thank you both so much for spending time with us today. This is so important. And, you know, like we said, Wisconsin, or maybe sometimes Pennsylvania, is ground zero, but the show is called As Goes Wisconsin. So we're going to say Wisconsin, Ari. And, but thank you so much.
To be it, right?
Yes, exactly. Thank you so much for spending time with us today.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Appreciate it.
Bye-bye. All right. Well, when we come back, Carol Kane is going to be here and we're going to have some fun. Her, Jane, and I talking about a little preview of what's to come Fridays this fall when she joins As Goes Wisconsin.
This summer, 540 AM WAUK has a new lineup. Mondays 8 to 9, Under the Helmet with the Gravedigger, Gilbert Brown and Earl Ingram on 540 AM WAUK.
CBS News Brief. The day after a day of deadly flooding in New York, Governor Kathy Hochul hails first responders.
They put their training to use. They did not think about their own safety. They literally went up to cars that were swirling at risk of being washed away, and they knocked and they made sure someone was safe.
Flooding causing issues throughout much of the Northeast. A man convicted of sexually abusing young female athletes has had a prison run-in, as we hear from CBS's Anne Marie Green.
Multiple sources confirmed to CBS News that sports doctor Larry Nassar has been stabbed in prison in Florida. Nassar is said to be in stable condition.
Well, CBS's Vicky Barker in London with more on President Biden's visit with King Charles.
The two shook hands, then stood side by side for the royal salute, then walked slowly among the rows of guards in their scarlet tunics and bearskin hats, reviewing the troops.
Next for Mr. Biden, a NATO summit. CBS News Brief. I'm Steve Kathan.
Looking for more local programming? Check out our website, civicmedia.us, to see our entire lineup.
For WAUK, The Shaw, I'm Terry Bell, and here's what you need to know. The 55th year of Summerfest is in the books. This was the third year of Summerfest's three-weekend format. Jimmy Buffett and AJR canceled their performances. Summerfest attendance is coming back up since the pandemic, but crowds are still smaller than they were before COVID. The official attendance for this year's Summerfest should be announced sometime this week. A Waukesha teacher who could be fired over Dolly Parton's Rainbow Land song has a hearing today. Melissa Temple is a first-grade teacher at Higher Elementary. She tweeted her objections when the song was removed from the school's spring concert. The story has made national news. The district says Temple's response was inappropriate and accuses her of violating district policies. I'm Terry Bell, and this is WAUK News.
Living happily ever after isn't always a reality. If you're over 50 and are considering divorce, attorney Andrea Gage with the Everson Law Firm can provide the guidance you need. Andrea focuses on silver divorces, the kind that get more complicated over time and present unique challenges. A family, multiple properties, significant assets. Andrea and the team at Everson Law have the experience to protect your interests. Call Everson Law to set up an appointment with Andrea today. It's never too late to be happy. Everson Law, 920-435-3734.
Attention, Wisconsin veterans.
Hello, I'm Tony Evers, the governor of Wisconsin. If you are a veteran struggling to pay for rent, utilities, or other life-sustaining services, I want you to know that the Veterans Rental Assistance Program is here to help. You have already made a most noble sacrifice. You shouldn't have to continue doing so. We are here to support you. The Veterans Rental Assistance Program was created by and for people living in Wisconsin, with benefit approvals being issued to veterans in just days, not months. It's never easy to ask for assistance, but rest assured, we're here to help. You've always been there for us. We want you to know that we're here for you. Call 833-WISBRAP. That's 833-947-8727. Or visit VRAPWI.com. On behalf of the state of Wisconsin, thank you.
It's easy to listen to your favorite local radio station anytime. Download the Civic Media app from the Apple or Google Play.
Welcome back to As Goes Wisconsin. I am Kristin Bry. She is Jane Matinere. And we are joined by another Southeast Wisconsin radio legend, Carol Kane.
Hi.
How are you doing, friend?
How are you, ladies? You look great.
You know, we're it's a Monday. We're here. We're on the other end of the show right now. But we're doing well. How are you doing?
Right now, I am completely addicted to Lost on Prime. Did you ever watch Lost?
I never got into Lost. Jane, you did?
Oh, for sure.
Oh,
absolutely.
My God. It's the best. It's the best. I have spent 3 days on my recliner doing nothing but one after the other. And I had no idea about the beefcake that was on that show. Look at Jane. See? Am I wrong?
Josh Holloway is one of the most beautiful men I've ever seen.
Oh, yikes. Beyond belief. My poor husband sits here on the couch, and every time he comes on the TV, I go, wow. He is something. And he's like, what am I? And I go, right now, you're chopped liver, my friend.
Wasn't he kind of the bad guy, though? Or wasn't he?
Yeah.
He was like the bad boy of that show, if I remember correctly.
The bad boy.
Yes.
He has his moments. But
a little of an anti-hero.
Yeah. Oh, God. So that's what I've been doing for the past few days. I know it's beautiful outside. I should get outside, but I can't.
You've earned it. Do what you want, Carol.
You know what? First of all, let me just take the time, Kristin, to say congratulations. I'm so happy for you. And here's what I'm going to tell you as a mom of two children. Your life is going to change, but it's going to be for the best. You're going to have the best time. The best.
I'm very excited. I feel like the benefit of being in your mid-30s when you have a kid is you have a lot of friends who've already had kids. And so there's a little bit more of like, I don't think anything totally prepares you. And no matter how many people tell you it's hard, you go through it and you're like, oh yeah, it's hard. They weren't lying. I am very excited. And so, I think Mike's excited too. Yeah. But
I can imagine. I mean, my kids are 34 and 30 right now. So it's been a while since I've done this, but as I've progressed through this and been their mom, it's so great for them to get to this point where, like, my daughter is my best traveling companion. She's the best. And we go out and we have the best time. And so, So much congratulation for you and Michael. I'm so happy for you.
Thank you. And thank you also for being willing to step up and step in, because we're so excited that the cat's out of the bag. And on Friday in Milwaukee Business Journal, they wrote a little article about how the fact that come Fridays this fall, you and Jane are going to have some fun on this show.
And you know what? It's so disappointing that I get to work with Jane, because I really don't like her.
We have to fake it really hard. We gotta really keep our personal feelings out of it and just pretend that we get along, Carol.
You know, I working know. Relationships, it's just for the sake of the show. We'll exactly. take it.
Oh, we exactly. take one for the team, but I'm so thrilled. I just love Janie so much, and she knows how much I adore her. And we've been, gosh, Jane, it's been 40 years, I think, that we've been friends, right?
Just about. It has to be close to, yeah.
I was going to ask that, because you were on separate stations.
Yeah.
And so you guys came up at the same time, but separate stations. And so there wasn't a rivalry at all?
Well, there was on air, Jane. I mean, we were always at, you know, we were always competitors. When we were supposed to beat one another, for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
When it came to the numbers. But the minute I met Jane, and she knows this story so very, very well. We were in a celebrity fashion show at the Wisconsin Club. And we did our little dog and pony show, both of us. We were representing our different stations. And at the end, Jane looked at me and she goes, "Hey, would you be interested in catching a cocktail someplace?" And I said, "Yes, I would." And we went down to this dive bar on Wisconsin Avenue in downtown Milwaukee. And we laughed and laughed and laughed. And I remember I came home and I said to my husband, I said, "I just spent the night with Jane Matinere and I have made a friend for life." Aww. I knew immediately. And she has seen me through some of the worst moments of my life. And I hope to think that I have helped her in many different regards too.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. And I just want to say too, that I think, Carol, when we first met and started talking that night, we have so many similarities in life, just because we're both from big families. We both have almost the same number of boys and girls. There are just a lot of things that we had in common to establish our friendship. And so, and we've never talked. We used to laugh about this when Carol and I would get together, not, you know, weekly or monthly, but we would certainly get together for drinks and we would laugh about how much our partners, our respective partners on our different stations, were worried about us trading insider secrets about what's going on at the other place. And it's like, we never talked about that. Never. Yeah. Never.
No, we never talked. We just never talked about it, just because of the fact that we had so much other stuff to talk about.
Yeah.
And I went to Jane's wedding. I was so grateful that she invited me to that. And I know Paul, and I just, I'm so looking forward to this. It's going to be fun. We're going to have fun.
It's also so interesting because the first time the three of us were in a room together was at a different station. I was filling in, and Carol, you and I were co-hosting for a day, and Jane came in and did the news. And I remember being in that soundproof booth. And I think the topic is actually interesting. And maybe we'll have to revisit this topic. Maybe I'll do a guest appearance on my own maternity leave. Because I remember it came up of who's harder on women, other women or men. And you both were convinced that other women are harder on women. And I was pretty adamant. And so it started being a generational thing. But then just like, I think you two have seen, it is a generational thing. And Jane and I talk about this a lot as far as how male dominated radio is and how much you, I mean, especially with, this has been both of your entire careers of spending it in radio and having to, shall we say, put up with a fair amount of stuff over
navigate.
The years. Navigate. That's maybe navigate. A better word. That's a more diplomatic word, Jane. And so it's been interesting. I mean, that was eye-opening for me as, you know, my kind of first forward, like, into radio was that day and hearing you guys talk about it. And so it's like, has that been a bonding like a part of your guys's friendship of just like dealing with some of the BS?
I would say probably, yeah. Even though I do think women are harder on women when it comes to certain things, I think this business is tough. without a doubt. And of course, recent history that everybody knows about now. But the thing is that I think that it treats, the industry treats aging men, particularly men, way different than women. I think women still, unfortunately, are disposable. I hate to say it, but I do think that that's the case.
And easily replaceable.
Yes, exactly. So I hope that at some point in time that changes. I'll probably be, I'm 64 years old, so I'll probably be dead by the time that it does. But, you know, at least somebody come over and do a novena over my grave and go, hey, it happened. It finally happened. but I, yeah, I, Jane, I think you would agree with me, right?
Absolutely. And I just have to laugh when I think about when I left my prior employer and some of my male colleagues asked me, why aren't there more women in radio? And I said, you're asking the wrong person. I've got the phone numbers of a bunch of guys you could probably call. Yeah. And well, do you think it's going to change? And again, I said, I'm not the right person to ask. There are people higher above in the food chain who make those decisions. And you can, I've known lots of talented people, Carol, who just didn't last.
Yes. And let me just say this. At my last radio station, which I'm still filling, so I'm filling in all over the place. I'm kind of a free agent. I loved the man I was working with. Absolutely adored him. And I think he's a quality man and I will miss working with him as long. And I'm just going to say that I did. I will miss him, but, you know, I'll do fill-ins for you. I'll do fill-ins for whatever. Basically, I'm just going to be a cheap radio, you know what, for money. Somebody wants to pay me, I'm on the wagon.
But I think that's something is how much you love radio, right? Like you love this career.
Well, I fell into it oddly. And I actually, how I got into this was, and Janie knows this story, I think. I took a radio 101 course at UW Whitewater. It was one credit. And somebody said, it's easy, just go. And so I had 14 credits. I needed 15 for full time. And so I did this class. And the man who was teaching it was straight out of terrestrial radio. And 2 weeks into the class, he pulled me in and he said, I want to get you started on the campus station. I want to get you started on the campus cable station. I think you could do this for a living. And I go, no. I'm going to be an English literature teacher. And he said, no, you're not. No. He goes, you're going to be in radio and I'm going to make sure you get in radio. And that's how I got started in it. So I think that's one of the most important things that whenever I talk to younger people who are in college, I say, listen to the people around you because they may know more than you think you know.
Or they may see things that you don't, that you're not aware of, you know, with skills, where you might be a good fit, things like that.
Right. So, I mean, it's, hey, Kristin, Jane, you and I have been in it for the same time. I mean, it's been over 40 years for me. I know I look 23. Wait.
Totally.
Completely.
But it's been, I mean, I can't argue. I hold my head high. There are very few people that have had the careers that Jane and I have had. We are very lucky.
We are. There's no question.
It's also the longevity. And like, I've done this. We just had our year anniversary of this show last week. And to think about like the day in and day out and like, you can't miss, like it's live radio. You can't do it later. And so the fact that both of you have the stamina that you've had to do it. And every day there's something, you gotta find something to talk about and you gotta get up and do it again. And so I guess on that note, cause we only have a couple minutes left. What are you gals going to talk about on Fridays come this fall?
Jane?
Well, we're going to keep the first hour pretty much the same because I really like our first newsy hour. And so we'll do, you know, the good, the bad, and the did you have to do that segments. And And then I think in the second segment, you know, Carol and I like to talk about lifestyle things and and some wackier, lighter things. But we're still going to do interviews and have guests. And if anybody's got suggestions of what they would like Carol and I to talk about for about 3 months, you can always email us at asgoeswisconsin@civicmedia.us.
Yeah, I think that it's Jane and I are to just kind of let it flow is just the what works for us. I know in the article it was addressed about politics and things like that. And I think Jane and I are going to, unless something huge breaks, we won't talk that much about it. It's just the way that our conversation flows, I think, is going to make it the most entertaining. I always say that I think the best radio is a party that you've been invited to, but you can't attend, but you want to eavesdrop on the conversation. And so I think that's kind of what it is. I think that's kind of what it's going to be.
Well, I'm very excited. I will certainly be listening from home, but I just, as I said, I think there is such a huge opportunity for more women voices on radio, because I think we talk about things in a way that you can't get anywhere else. And I think we're doing it on this show. And Carol, I'm so excited, even though I won't be here, I'm so excited that you will be here to keep doing it with Jane in my absence. And, you know, and then we'll just have to keep you coming back during 2024 once I'm back.
Well, thank you for asking me. I really appreciate it. And I'm just going to put this out that, I'm not a good babysitter.
Jane said she's just a little babysitter. Oh, are we good? Did we go to commercial? Jane?
This summer, 5:40 a.m. WAUK has a new lineup.
Yes, that's awesome.
Starting at 6 a.m. Up North News, 8 to 10, The Earl Ingram Show. Mondays, 8 to 9, Under the Helmet with the Grave Digger, Gilbert Brown and Earl Ingram. 10 to 12, As Goes Wisconsin. At noon, Civic Media Network News. At 12:15, Town Call. 1 to 3, The Todd Alba Show. 3 to 4, Matt Flynn Direct. 4 to 6, The Devil's Advocates with Dom and Crute. And 6 to 7, The Maggie Dawn Show. On 5:40 a.m. WAUK.
A no-holds-barred political conversation. That's Matt Flynn Direct.
This is a scam, and Tucker Carlson is one of the guys. He's one of the guys who said the election was stolen, Dominion voting machines are no good, on the air, but in the background, he's going, this is insane. This is a load of bull. The guy lies for a living. He lies with a straight face.
Matt Flynn Direct, weekday afternoons from 3 until 4. On the Civic Media Network and on the Civic Media app. Direct from the Dairy State, it's Sharp Cheddar Weekends, a 3-hour block of Wisconsin produced radio, Saturdays and Sundays from 11 a.m. till 2 p.m., featuring Raised in Wisco with Joe Clayfish and Danielle Fairman, The Cripes Cast with Charlie Behrens, and Under the Helmet with the Gravedigger, Gilbert Brown. You can enjoy it by the slice or enjoy the whole darn thing. Sharp Cheddar Weekends is radio so fresh, it squeaks. Listen in on the Civic Media station or on the app.
Here's your updated forecast on the Shaw. Mainly sunny this afternoon, high in the upper 80s. A few clouds tonight, chance of showers and thunderstorms, low near 66. Slight chance of showers and storms early Tuesday. Mainly sunny, high of 81. Slight chance of rain Tuesday night, low near 59. Cloudy on Wednesday, chance of showers and a few thunderstorms, high of 72. Showers and storms likely Wednesday night. For Civic Media, I'm meteorologist Laura Lockwood. Right now, 79.
You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.
Welcome back to As Goes Wisconsin. I'm Kristin Bry, along with Jane Matinair and Carol Kane. And we're so excited that Carol is going to be joining on Fridays come this fall. I think the last week of September is when, unless this kid comes way early, the last week of September is when you kick off.
Yeah, I think like the 29th or something, isn't it, Jane?
Yeah, it's the 29th.
Yeah.
September 29th and then through the end of December. Yeah. And it's going to be a ball. And I know, Carol, you have a big, big following on social media. Have you heard from your Facebook friends when after the article dropped on Friday on the Milwaukee Business Journal?
Yeah. Yeah, I am. I'm so very grateful that people are, there's something that I'm not exactly sure how it happened. I think it's just because I talk about my life and talk about my family and people connected and we kind of grew up together, and it's been a wonderful emotional connection, and they've been there for me and I'm there for them. I will do anything that they possibly, if they need help, I'm there. I think that resonates with people when I truly am. I'm just a normal person. I'm just regular. I'm regular Carol who has an odd job.
And you are very much yourself, Carol. And you are, I mean, you don't pull any punches. The things that you have shared about your life, you're brutal. You are.
No, I mean, I truly, and no, it's the truth. I know. I say anything and everything. If you want to know anything, all you got to do is ask me. I'll tell you. It really doesn't matter. Because I'm just a regular, normal individual. I mean, one of the classic stories, and Jane, you know this, is me leaving my daughter at the gas station for Pete's sake.
Wait, on purpose?
No. It was a horrible thing. And
now you have to tell this story.
I thought she was in the car. She wanted to pump the gas. She wanted to pay for the gas. The door closed. I thought she was in the car. I take off. I'm at Mequon and Port Washington Road. I'm talking to her all the way down to Capitol. I'm not getting any answer. And I turn around and all that's in the backseat is her stuffed seal. This is what you've got to look forward to, Kristin. This is the stuff. And then all of a sudden I called my husband and all I hear is, ha, ha, ha. And I go, and screaming in the back. And I go, tell me you have our daughter. And he goes, yeah, I do. You left her at the gas station. And apparently while I was playing her Backstreet Boys, she's pounding on the trunk, screaming, mom, 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 as I'm driving away. I call that the day that Elizabeth almost got a pony. I almost got a horse. I'm like, that's it. I'm the worst mom in the world. So yeah, yeah. That's the story.
That is, and honestly, I am forgetful enough that I may have a story like that someday as well. But that was probably way before there was any cell phones or anything to immediately go, all right, I'll be right back.
It was awful. It was awful. And my husband just laughed. He thought it was hilarious. Right, Janie? You know Lou. He's just like, oh, huh. Look He's at you, most, I'm good dad now.
The most easygoing guy, your husband. He really is. Very chill, doesn't get, you know, flapped about much. So I can just see him going, yeah, well, that's, you know, it happens.
No one got hurt. Yeah, everyone's fine.
Misplaced a child every once in a while.
That's the kind of stuff that people that they related to, and they're very kind. And so, yes, to answer your question, I've heard an awful lot from a lot of people. So,
but I think too, Carol, people have always been so welcoming. To me, to you, they listen to us in the bathroom and at the supper table and having breakfast and in the car and in the bedroom. And I've just always felt like we're all a family, right? It's all family members. Some drive us a little crazier than others, but you still love them. Yep. And it's just been, and I've always thought too that Southeastern Wisconsin in particular was an interesting media market. Because people are so loyal.
Yes.
Right?
That's interesting.
People are really, really loyal. They like you, they like you.
Once they like you, they like you. And it takes an awful lot to turn them against you. And so far that hasn't happened. So far, Jane and I and you have been very lucky. And I'm very grateful for that. I'm very grateful. This is a wonderful community and people here are so kind and they're generous. And
well, look at some of the fundraisers that you and I have done over the decades, and the generosity of people never failed to blow my mind. And it's at least in my opinion, it was never the fancy Lexus that was coming up and dropping off $500 worth of groceries. It was the crappy panel station wagon.
Yep.
It's got a bunch of dings and dents in it. And they would just come and blow us away with their generosity.
There is something about this area. I had one charity say to me, do you realize that we have here in the state of Wisconsin, in southern Wisconsin particularly, there's a 98% of return, which I found fascinating. That was a fascinating statistic. Out of the 100% people who donate, 98% will fulfill their donation.
Oh, wow.
And he said, yeah, I thought that was a fascinating statistic. And I said, well, what is it in other places? He goes, in other places in the nation, we're lucky if we get 50%. They donate, they're drawn to donate, but they don't fulfill their donation. But that doesn't apply here in southeastern Wisconsin or in the state of Wisconsin. We have a 98% of return.
See, which we don't like,
that says it all.
We don't like cheaters.
We don't like cheaters.
We don't like cheaters.
We like to be generous.
Yes.
It's that's a great statistic. All right. Well, Carol Kane, we can't wait to have you starting end of September, Fridays. Carol will be here with Jane.
Yep.
I will not call you for babysitting. Jane has already made it abundantly clear that she's good with babies. And then as soon as they have a personality, she wants nothing to do with them.
Exactly. Send them to boarding school.
You know what? At the very last minute, if you need somebody, I will come down and help you. But always advocate for somebody different.
Somebody else first. All right. Well, Carol, thank you so much for spending time with us today.
Can't wait to get you on the show.
And that's about it for us today. Come back tomorrow at 10 a.m. and we will do it all over again. This has been As Goes Wisconsin. Thank you for calling. Thank you for texting. Thank you for being part of the show, as always. And we'll see you tomorrow.
You got a friend in me. Some other folks might be a little bit sad.